Hi everyone, this is Manoj, your German coach, and this is Anna, our German coach from Dresden. Anna, thank you very much again for our next part, which is adjective ending in dative cases. That's what we are going to discuss today. So, letztes Mal haben wir über akkusative adjektive Deklination gesprochen und auch nominative adjektive Deklination. Wie und wann werden die Deklinationen an den Adjektiven gegeben und wie verwenden wir? Heute reden wir über die Deklination.
So, would you please try to explain, or do you want me to explain how dative adjective endings work? It's very easy to learn.
You can start and I will pitch in if you want.
Wonderful. So in dative, we have two cases, whether the adjective is with the article or it is without article. Mit article, ohne article. So let's first talk about the articles. Dative articles, we have dem, der, dem. Dem for masculine, der for feminine, and dem for neutral. In unbestimmt, we have einem, einer, einem. Plural, den, den, den. And in all these cases, adjective always take en irrespective of the article. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. Mm-hmm.
So that means if I want to give an example, ich gebe dem intelligenten Mann einen neuen Kuli. Is that correct?
Is that right? So we have to think about, we have the dem, and it's really super rare. It will come later in more advanced grammar that we have two ends. So just remember, if you're a beginner, mostly it is dem, and then we have something with en at the end. Yeah, dem schönen dem schönen Mann. Dem schönen something something. Mm-hmm. So yes, for male it is dem, and then we have en for the adjective. You said it correctly. Mm-hmm.
Correct. And when we do not have any article, or when we say adjective declination ohne article, how do we work? So in case of masculine, we say with einem. When we don't have article, the masculine singular takes em.
Dem Stift, for example.
Correct. Feminine singular, we have ER because it takes the dative der. And neutral, we again have EM. Is that correct?
It's correct, yes, without any adjective.
Mm-hmm. And for plural, because the article is den, all plural dative endings takes EN adjective.
Right. So it's super easy to remember, actually. So people are really thankful that it doesn't change much according to the gender. So it's always den blauen Stiften, den grauen Zügen. It's all the same.
Correct. Correct. So do we have some exercises about this one? Can we directly take our participant to the exercise?
Yes, I prepared some exercise for the second segment, but if we can also talk a little bit here, for me, maybe for you also as a language coach, it's maybe important to say, when do we use dative? Because to use it, we need to know why. So how do we say, for example, with the preposition aus? So how do we say, I come from a wealthy home, for example?
Okay, ich komme aus Indien.
Genau. And then we have, for example, Familie, die Familie, right? So we want to say, I come from a rich family, or she comes from a rich family, whatever, just for exampling.
Do we say, ich komme aus einer reichen Familie?
Perfect, yeah, super, right? Ich komme aus einer reichen Familie. So now we know, okay, preposition is aus, this is dative. Of course, there are exceptions. It's not every preposition is for one case. Those are called Wechselpräposition. But okay, we are A1 level now. Ich komme aus einer reichen Familie. And then we know how to do that. Yeah, you want to do a second one before we go to the exercises?
Absolutely. But before, I mean, the way I explain my participants about the dative explanation is little different. I don't know whether I am correct or not. You can correct me. So dative case, whenever we have an indirect object involved, not the direct object. An indirect object means whenever some person has to do with or is used as an object. I am buying a pen. I am buying a pen for my sister. Now, in this case, for my sister is my indirect object, because the dative case. Ich kaufe meiner Schwester einen neuen Kuli.
Sehr schön, genau. Right. Yeah. So the indirect thing is a good explanation, because we don't have it in English. I always say to my students, the only thing that's come similar, it's like I'm buying him something, right? It's like the only thing that comes quite similar. But of course, it's much more complicated in German. So yeah, the indirect object is a good way to explain that.
And can we also say, ich kaufe einen neuen Kuli für meine Schwester? Can we also say that? Möglichkeiten sind okay. Okay, that means, ich kaufe meiner Schwester einen neuen Kuli. If I want to bring an adjective, intelligent, ich kaufe meiner intelligenten Schwester einen neuen Kuli.
Genau. Ich kaufe ihr. Then we know, this is that case. And then we know, okay, ich kaufe meiner kleinen Schwester ein Geschenk.
Wonderful. So let's take our participant directly to your section, which is the Arbeitsblatt or Aufgaben, and we see there. Guys, for exercises, we go to Anna's channel and learn.